Here is El Tesoro de la Vida, the treasure of life. Here, children forced to face death decades too soon come together to learn that grief is not theirs alone. And most importantly, they find out they're not alone.
No one is going to think they're strange when they say, "My mom was murdered," where if they said that in seventh grade, you know, in school, people might think they were strange.
And you guys know for sure that everyone here has had someone in their life that died. But sometimes you don't know who, and sometimes you don't know anyone who's like you. If you have had a mother who died, please stand up. If you have had a father who died, please stand up. Take a look around at all the people who are like you.
Can't always choose the way you hurt, but you can choose the way you heal. No one here is sure who to give credit to that wise saying, but here, credit is not important. Here, what's important is healing.
Quantasia Royal, Quanti to her friends, struggles with the loss of her brother Terrence.
He had cancer.
She was just 5 when she stood at his hospital bed, watched and knew when Terrence's brain tumor had finally won.
Because his head was leaning over to the side like that, and he didn't answer us, and his eyes was open.
On the bridge, it was real special for Quanti to know that when she has those emotions, it's okay. It's okay. It's good, really.
Life doesn't always turn out the way you think it's going to. I mean, of course, there are kids that are in my position. I'm not the only one, but for me, I've had to grow up so fast.
Life floored its accelerator at Connie Evans back in January when the 16-year-old Carrollton girl walked straight into a nightmare.
Nobody's ever going to know what took place. I mean, there's no way. But my father killed my mother, and then he killed himself.
I'm getting to where I'm very proud of myself. And I'm mad because my mom and dad aren't here to see it.
We want them to be angry. We want them to be mad. We want them to cry. If they need to be mad at the person who died, that's okay. And that's really hard for a child, because how can I be mad at my dad who's dead?
But this camp does not aim to corral kids' feelings. To the contrary, El Tesoro de la Vida seeks to shed the pain.
Blow your bubbles and then shout out goodbye to whoever it is that you love.
Bye, Mama.
Bye, Papa. Bye, Trevor.
While it carefully comforts
goodbye,
this special communion of children.
Goodbye, brother.
Suddenly they have gone from being withdrawn and pulled in and scared and withdrawn to being just wide open and open to the process and to seeing what happens. It's just like there's a light goes on. People want to avoid pain. We don't like pain, and pain's inevitable, and that's part of what we do here at camp is normalize that.
It has taken 12-year-old Daniel Alvarez 3 summers of this camp to trust enough to share the loss of his mom and his grandmother.
I learned that it's okay to cry and when you lose somebody. And I learned also that it's okay to talk out your feelings.
Well, my father's death was just like a cut, and this place is like the Band-Aid.
They will look back, hopefully, on this, and it'll be a pivotal point. Some kids, they will have to shut the door again to survive, but now they know the door can be opened and shut. Whereas before, they may have come here and thinking the door was welded shut. Somebody.
I met friends that were kind of like me and got to talk about it a lot. Stuff that I usually didn't get to do a lot. It was hard at first, but I learned that he would probably want me to be having fun.
Well, we say that camp is 90% fun, but 10% therapy. Actually, the whole camp is therapeutic, of course. Many of these kids, if she's the oldest daughter, then she's having to be the mother in the family. If it's the oldest son, they're taking on the father role because the father died. Sometimes it's not safe to laugh in the house anymore or right now because it's still so sad. It would seem disrespectful. So our goal here is really this week is about them just being a kid. We say that they're kids first and grievers second. It's about them running and playing and doing horseback and archery and fishing and hiking and all the things that you do at camp. It's all therapeutic for them. One of the biggest challenges that we face is finding funding to make sure that we never have to turn a child away. This year is our record-breaking year, and we have more kids than we've ever had as word gets out. That's both sad and good that there's a place for it, sad that we have to have it. But I'd say the most difficult part is making sure that we work all year long to have enough money to make sure that no kid ever gets turned away.
As this year's memorial tree takes root, and the most precious headstones ever made are nestled nearby, a sign, El Tesoro de la Vida, has succeeded once again. These special campers start talking and acting like any summer camper.
When I get home, I want to go to Taco Bell and again. I really do. I'm hungry.
De la Vida gives kids like me an opportunity to have fun.
You know, I have thought about this moment for a year now, how to wrap up this special nice and neat. But I can't do it. I can't do it because grief is neither neat nor tidy. It has been 30 years, and I still miss my dad's smile. Connie still misses her mom. And Kelsey still misses hearing her father compose music at 2 a.m. In our own ways, we'll miss them always. But as someone said, what the heart has owned, we'll never lose.
I hope you never lose your sense of wonder. You get your fill to eat, but always keep that hunger. May you never take one single breath for granted. God forbid love ever leave you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you never fear those mountains in the distance. Never settle for the path of least resistance. Living might mean taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some helping heart leave you bitter. When you come close to selling out, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing. When you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you do.
Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance.